They thought ending the world would end the war. That much was passed down. Everything else has been lost. When the bombs dropped, 80% of Australia's population was wiped out, just like that. Those who weren't immediately vaporised carried the radiation inland, poisoning all the pretty places they crawled to. The desert swallowed the rest. Despite it all, we survived. We rebuilt. We even formed strong enough allegiances to have wars of our own. But these wars were of disease, of hunger, of people who'd forgotten the sacrifices that have always been made beyond the steady glows of the cities that now choked with dust. Our great-grandparents made it. We will too. All it takes to thrive in this new world is guts, grit, and hard yakka. That's where you come in.
Thank you. You made it. Good. My name's Jake. Jake Anderson. And this here's Bally Bally Hall. Truth to tell, wasn't sure you'd make it. Between the wildlife and the attacks we'd seen, but you might have met with some misadventure. Alderside's dropped off the radio waves. Could be nothing, it could be something. Either way, Surveyor's Guild wants you to take a look. Me and Jonesy will tag along to help out, in case it's the something. Then we'll head to Kokobie to escort our mate Mick back to Brookton. Sounds simple, but Mick's the mayor of the bloody town, so let's all just get him home in one piece, yeah? It's an easy job, not expecting much trouble, but better safe than sorry, yeah? Let me introduce you around. Ella's over here, she's my second. My cousin too, her and her sister Mad, who's keeping watch from the crow's nest. Don't get on their bad sides.
New blood, eh, Jake?
New Surveyor, remember how I told you the Guild's updating its maps for the area and hired us for protection? This is it. Figured we'd make Alderside the first stop, since we haven't heard from him in a while. Jonesy and I are going to make sure everyone's cozy and safe. While we prep for the trip, why don't you show the newcomer around?
Brookton boy, who fixed up our tow truck and keeps the radio systems in order. Kind of the go-to fixer for anything Mad can't do. Decent enough engineer. Talks a lot, though. Just shut him up if you're feeling like it. Any other questions? Or should we get moving? Handles blades and small arms. Tough guy. Jonesy's really fucking good in a bind. His dad's the mayor of Brookton, Mick. You'll meet him later today. Any other questions? Or should we get moving? My sister. She does a bit of mechanic work from time to time and keeps things running smoothly here. Never really seemed to take to people very well. Or maybe people never really took to her. You'll see for yourself soon enough.
Anyway, she's part of the crew, but don't take it personally if she doesn't want to be pals. Any other questions? Or should we get moving?
That's Mishti. Whipped behind the ears, only 18 years old, but a mad talent for negotiating. She saved us some bullets and bandages for sure. Call her Dreamer, because she has big ideas of crossing the Nullarbor and seeing the world. Right now, she's busy sorting through inventory and storage just past the hall. Probably never dreamed of that.
Any other questions? Or should we get moving? Let's go.
Who's this then?
Surveyor, the guilds asked us to see why no one can raise Alderside on the radio. Jake and Jonesy are going to be an escort for this one while we head on to Kokobi.
Thank you.
Sure thing. Good luck in Aldeside.
Get a chance to talk to everyone yet? No? Best get on it then. Thank you.
Matt, the surveyor's headed to Alderside with Jake and Jonesy. That's all we're gonna get out of her. Come on, let's go.
Name's Jonesy, mate. Who are you?
That trip you and Jake are taking to Alderside. Seems he's coming with you. Surveyor's Guild wants to check the place out, too. Don't let him fool you. Under that bloodthirsty exterior lurks, well, the heart of a killer. But under that, not a bad guy. Not if he's on your side. Well, unless you're a farmer. Then you should lock up your wife and daughters, livestock too.
Ah, you know me so well, Ellie. Except the livestock thing. No one can prove that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Heard you're having your chin wags with everyone. How you finding Ella? She's rough around the edges, but then we all are. It's why I like to have her score higher people around. Anyway, what do you think of the place? Not that there's been a flood in my lifetime, but Grandma did mention wading through water tits deep with a baby camel over her shoulders back when they were first getting set up. She really thought of everything when she designed this place. Anyway, it's about time to head to Alderside, yeah? Should be safe and easy. When we've wrapped up there, we'll meet up with the others up in Kokobi, and then we'll meet up with Mick, Brookton's leader, and follow them back to Brookton. Mick can be a real charmer, or he can be a right bastard. He's a hard man, so it's best not to bullshit him. He's Jonesy's adopted dad, so once you meet him, you'll understand Jonesy better. Anything else you need from Bally Bally before we go? Reckon we'll start with Alderside, like I was saying to Ella. They've been off the radio, so I'd like to check in and make sure they're alright. After that, we'll head up to Kokobi, where you can poke around and chat with the station master, Tina. Family land, ain't it? The great-grands bought it back in the day. They saw the big fuck-up coming, pardon my French, and got wise. Stocked the place up and raised their kids. Taught them how to survive out here. Then they raised my parents. My parents raised me. Ancestral birthright, eh? You're standing in it. After World War shit, my folks decided they might as well make themselves useful. Being a scout's family tradition at this point, and since I'm the oldest by a fair bit, I'm the one in charge. Then it's Ella, then Matt. Though that one needs a little more time in the oven. Don't reckon she's got the right temperament for a leader, you know? There's plenty in the bush to fill your pants with piss. What with the snakes and spiders and scorpions. So many scorpions. A real shit ton. But nothing to worry about, really. Keep your eyes peeled, your ears open, shake out your boots before you put them on, and you'll be fine. Ho, ho, ho. I would be deeply offended if I was smart enough to understand that, I'm sure. But look, keep your skin in one piece, yeah? And this goes double for you, Mishti. If you're outside the gate, don't let your guard down. Welcome to Alderside, mate.
Thin, ashen-faced man hides behind the tree, clutching a hand over his belly. His shirt is soaking up the blood from a horrific wound. He's gasping for air, but waves his other hand at you, shooing you off.
Oi, Alderside! It's Jake with the scouts! Don't fucking shoot! Enough chit-chat. That was a bloody mess, eh? Literally. And nothing really gained either. Don't shoot, you pricks! Couple things. First, you've been off the radio for a while. Neighbours started to get a little concerned, you know. Asked us to come down and make sure you lot are okay. Thank you. Right, we've seen what we need to see here. Ready to head out to Kokobi? Let's see what we can find, yeah?
Keep an eye on Ames. He's a dodgy bastard.
Thank you.
Right, we've seen what we need to see here. Ready to head out to... I think we've probably gotten all we're going to get out of these people. Right, we've seen what we need to...